Good morning. Welcome again to Morning Devotions. And thank you again so much for our time together. It's a beautiful Monday morning. It's going to be a great week this week. And God is going to bless all the work of your hands. As we get started with this week, let me begin to talk to you about the principle that Paul lived his life by. It's what I call the principle of focus. He starts in verse 7 of 1 Timothy chapter 2. And for this purpose, I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth, I'm not lying, and a teacher of the true faith to the Gentiles. He said, you want to know the primary focus of my ministry? It was to this people group. Now, I've had people all of my life come up to me and say, Pastor Samuel, why won't you go preach in all these other churches? Why won't you travel around the Philippines more? Why won't you do this? Why won't you do that? And I look at sometimes at people and go, excuse me, I preach Tuesday night, Wednesday night, Thursday night, Friday night, usually twice on Saturday because we do a fellowship in the morning, four times on Sunday, and then leadership or board meetings on Sunday night. Now, when would you exactly like me to run around and preach for all these other churches? I said, now that's one thing. I said, now the second thing is, what is the focus of my ministry? 35 years ago, as a 23-year-old young man, God asked me to do one thing. And God has not asked me to do a lot with my life. God asked me to look out for the welfare of a group of people here at Cathedral of Praise, what was then called Manila Bethel Temple. And I spent my lifetime focused on one congregation, focused on one city, focused on one nation, and focused on one type of people, the Pinoy. Now, I've had many friends all across my life that have told me, you need to do this, you need to do that, you need to go here, you need to go there. You know, oh, you need to go to Europe and preach. Why? That's not the focus of my ministry. You need to go here and spend more time. That's not the focus of my ministry. You need to go here and spend more time. That's not the focus of my ministry. Just like Paul had a focus of his ministry upon the Gentiles, the focus of my ministry is upon the Pinoy. And then more specifically, upon Metro Manila. And then more specifically, upon one congregation, the Cathedral of Praise. Now, I do not have any great desire to build a ministry to change the world. You know what? Jesus already changed the world. What I do have a great desire for is to do the simple things God asked me to do, and that is to focus on one set of people, because nobody else is focused on them, because these are the people I'm supposed to focus on. Now, what you need to learn to do with your life is ask yourself the question, not just what to do, but who you're supposed to do it with. Let me say that again. Not just what you're supposed to do, but who you're supposed to do it with. What is the long-term people focus of your life? What is the long-term people focus of your business? Now, when you begin to get zeroed in on the focus of your life, you're going to find that you can be very, very successful, and you have no need to try to keep up with anybody else or compete with anybody else or be what anybody else wants you to be, because you know you're fulfilling the one thing God asks you to do. Now, brothers and sisters, my thought for you today on this beautiful Monday morning as you begin this week is, Paul lived a very focused life. Let me say that again. Paul lived a very focused life. And he fulfilled what God wanted him to do. He said, I've finished my work. There will come a day when I will know in my heart I've finished my work. But you can never be finished with your work if you don't even know what the focus of the work is. I challenge each of you, spend enough time in prayer that you know the will of God with such certainty that you know the focus of your life.